Growing up, I spent a lot of time overseas. My father worked in the U.S. Foreign Service. From 1961, when I was 3 years old, until I was 13, every few years we would move to a new country. I lived in Ethiopia, Ghana, Senegal, Guinea. I traveled to Brazil, Germany, Yugoslavia, Sweden, Syria, Iran, and many more. In these countries, I went to international schools as a child of a diplomat. These schools were filled with kids from all over the world, every race, color, creed, and ethnicity. The classroom looked like a United Nations of children. In a way, it was a United Nations of children. Growing up in this environment, you might think I'd have appreciated this multicultural upbringing. You'd be wrong. I wasn't even aware of multiculturalism as a concept because it was just the way it was in my world. But when I came back to the United States, I became aware of it very quickly. I saw the segregation here, black schools, white schools. It was like moving backwards from color TV to black and white. As I got older, I realized that while overseas, I was living 10 years ahead of my time. That multicultural environment had yet to come to my own country. When I came back to return to school in America, it was a culture shock. There were cliques of different types of students, the jocks, the nerds, the potheads, etc. And they didn't interact with each other too much. And when in class, we learned about structures like the Eiffel Tower, the pyramids, the Berlin Wall, and others, I realized that while I had been to all of those sites, most of my classmates would only ever see their pictures in the textbook. I had seen a world of all sorts of people that could come together into one community, but they had been raised in a world where different groups didn't interact. I've been to 57 countries on every continent except Antarctica. I've played music in every state except Alaska. I've gotten along with every kind of person all over the world. The idea that we all can't get along is stupid. My life proves it. What I've learned is every single person, no matter how different from myself, all over the world, has the same five core values encoded within us. We all want to be loved. We want to be respected. We want to be treated fairly. We want to be heard. And we want the same thing for our family as everybody else wants for their family. Kindness is treating even those we might consider our worst enemies with these values. It can be hard to do this. It can be hard to love those who don't treat us well. It's hard to respect those we think are wrong. It's hard to treat fairly those we feel have privilege over us. It's hard to want to hear those who don't want to hear us. But no matter how hard it is, it's worth being kind. When we return hate with hate, frustration with frustration, unkindness with unkindness, it creates a toxic cycle. But when we return negativity with kindness, we help teach others to be kind. We have the opportunity to break the cycle. When one person learns habits of kindness, they treat others with kindness, and then it creates a snowball effect. One person's kindness has the power to change the world. Let me prove it. My life's work has been racial reconciliation. I have befriended those who might otherwise be considered my worst enemies, white supremacists, and I've lived the effect kindness can have. My friendship with Roger Kelly, the former Imperial Wizard of the Ku Klux Klan, led to the crumbling of the entire Maryland faction of the Klan, along with several other states. I treated him with love, respect, fairness. I let him be heard. And as he received those values, he started to treat others better too. Rather than referring to his nemesis using the typical racist and anti-Semitic epithets, he started to refer to them simply as blacks and Jews. He started being willing to see my friends and I as people rather than as simply skin colors. And then as he started to open his mind, he started receiving hate from his fellow Klansmen for his friendship with me, and he realized how much better kindness felt. He eventually realized he was no longer the person he once was. I have repeated this process dozens of times over 4 decades. It doesn't work every time, but if someone gives me the opportunity to treat them with kindness, 9 out of 10 times, they'll return the kindness back. And over time, I've watched it change the most hateful people into better members of our society. When people realize they have more in common than they do in contrast, it opens up a whole nother world for them. This isn't just about race. This is about how we treat everyone. If I, as a black man, can treat a KKK member with kindness and see him change, then you are capable of treating those with political differences, those you're arguing with on social media, those who are of a different gender or sexual identity or religion or whatever it may be, with kindness too. Changing the world starts with you. I'm Darryl Davis. Be pro-human with me at fairforall.org.